Welcome. It's good to be here with you today. We have a special treat for you as we last month, middle of the month, we got our next vicar, yeah. Tim and his wife Amber, moved to Warner Robins in July. And we thought with everything going on with COVID, that it'd be a really wonderful opportunity for those of you that haven't met them yet to meet and greet them digitally. And so, Tim and Amber, we welcome you, and we're glad that you're able to sit down and talk about who you are and share who you are a little bit with our congregation. For those of you that are watching in our community, or you've been connected with us along the way, and periodically you see our vicars in preaching and teaching Bible study and doing the daily devotions, a vicar in the Lutheran Church is really a pastoral intern. Every one of our pastors in our church body at one point was a vicar. I was a vicar, and it's really kind of your third year of the seminary experience. You kind of do an on-site internship at a congregation, and you learn and pretty much do everything a pastor would do in that kind of calendar year. And then you go back for a fourth year and finish your seminary degree and get placed in a congregation. So that's what a vicar is, and Tim is our vicar this year. Yep. And so where are you guys from? Tell us where you guys are originally from, where you grew up, and tell them about that.
Yeah, so I am from Glenview, Illinois. It's about 20 minutes north of Chicago. The closest town here is Evanston that most people know, because Northwestern University is there. Smart kids of the Big Ten. My dad was a pastor at Emmanuel Glenview, and my mom is DCE there, so I grew up in a church work family.
I'm from Fond du Lac, Wisconsin, so it's a smaller city. Most people outside of Wisconsin haven't heard of it, but pretty much everyone in Wisconsin at least is familiar with Fond du Lac. It is about an hour away from Milwaukee.
Well, great. So it sounds like about six months from now, when we're like in January or February, we're going to have totally opposite weather than what you're used to. Are you ready for that? To not take a winter in the Midwest?
Yeah, we're pretty excited for that.
So you guys, as husband and wife, where did your paths cross? Where did you first meet?
Yeah. So we both attended Wisconsin Lutheran College in Milwaukee. It's a Wells version of Concordia without any church work. They have a different college for that up in Minnesota, so that's even more isolated. So at WLC, I sat on the bench for 4 years and played football. And Amber's roommate was equipment manager. And so I got to know Renee, and then naturally hanging out on weekends. Tiny college, you get to know most people.
Sure.
And so it's through Renee, I met Amber. And she married one of my friends, and I married one of her friends, so that worked.
Yeah.
Wonderful. So when did you guys get married?
So we got married last October, so we'll be coming up on a year in a couple months.
So, wonderful. Yeah. So you're going to have your first year anniversary while you're here with us in Georgia.
Yep.
Well, that's great. That's great.
I think I preached on that day.
Okay. Wonderful. Wonderful. So what were you both doing while Tim, talk about what you were doing. You were a student, right?
I didn't know I was going to seminary until March of our senior year of college. So it was kind of like a hurried process to apply. And then I think a month after I graduated, I was in St. Louis taking summer Greek. And so for the last 2 years up until now, I've been at school doing summer Greek, all classes in the fall and spring, and then summer Hebrew, and then fall and spring. So I've been mostly studying.
Amber's been a student.
Amber's had a lot more fun.
Right.
Yeah, I was back at home with my parents in Wisconsin for that first year. So I was working at a nursing home, and I was doing activities, so that was a lot of fun getting to kind of, it was like my first experience having a job with that population, so it was pretty cool. And then I got to apply my art background.
Wonderful. That's great. Walk us through a little bit how you got to be here at Mount Calvary in Warner Robins. Yeah. There's a vicarage placement process. Mm-hmm. Talk about how that was and how it was different than it normally is.
Yeah. So vicarage placement is kind of a process over your first 2 years, kind of always under the scope of being watched. You know, your grades are being watched, how you talk and relate to people. Just trying to figure out your personality to figure out who you can best work with. But really your second year kind of gets amped up. So we got married in October, and then in November we had one interview with Dr. Nielsen, and then about 45 minutes he got all the information he needed from us to figure out where to put us. And so he was asking questions kind of like where we wanted to go, what we wanted in the church, and so we asked for not the Midwest, break out of that shell, and to try a different kind of church, a bigger church, because I'm from a tiny church back home. Mm-hmm. And then we kind of get radio silence for 5 months until call day as vicars. So, yeah, vicars are in completely blind in where they're going until that service. And this year it was online rather than in person. So we had to wait an extra 4 hours because usually vicars are at 3 and calls are at 7, but they did it all at once, and so they made us wait an extra 4 hours that day.
So they had a virtual placement service this year, and I know many of you tuned in and watched that. I've been on the receiving end of that twice, so I know a little bit whether it was in the seminary chapel or in your apartment. I still think the nerves and the angst and the wondering. It was still the same. But we're really looking forward to having you both here. Mm-hmm. Is there anything that you want them to know about you as you kind of begin this year with us?
So I'm very interested in art, anything arts and crafts related. So, you know, if anyone wants to hit me up to come over and paint or something, I'm definitely down.
And we're open most of the time. My office door is always open if you want to come in and meet me. The staff is pretty open too, if you want to come in and chat with us. But the biggest thing is I'm a Florida Gator fan. It's pretty deep in my blood, so I can't wear anything with UGA. I think my skin might boil, and I'd be disowned by my father. And so I'm kind of stuck with my blue and orange this fall, and hopefully there is a season, and hopefully there is a game in October. Or no, that's November this year.
So as you hear, you are not going to convince him to cheer for the red and black.
I can't.
And I think you're not going to convince many of us here either.
It's okay.
And it should make a fun year for us. Yep. Well, we just want to say thank you for being here with us today. And I just want to close with a word of prayer and pray over you guys that your ministry and year with us would be a blessing to not only Mount Calvary, but the Warner Robins community. So let's say a prayer. Lord God, Heavenly Father, you have answered our call for us as a church at Mount Calvary. We strive to serve the church at large and how we can be a blessing to other churches and ministry down the road. Well, we have that opportunity as we take Tim and Amber under our wings this year. I pray that you would bless their year among us, that they would continually learn and grow as they are striving to be a pastor and a pastor's wife one day, and that this is a part of the journey that you're training and calling them into service and ministry in your church. And Lord, we just ask that our life together would be enriched and strengthened by the heart of the gospel, that the love of Jesus Christ would just make this relationship, even though it's only 12 months, that it just would be a wonderful relationship and time together. And we just ask that for your blessing upon it. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Well, thank you guys for doing this with us, and I know many of you will probably appreciate hearing and enjoying them and meeting them and getting to know them better as their time here goes on. Well, thank you.
Thank you.
And blessings to you this week as we follow Jesus Christ.